Wow, there is a lot going on right here. Each of these animations are synchronized to the music, but it didn't take that long to animate them because of a feature in Blender called Bake Sound to F-Curves. Hi, my name is Brandon, and I'm going to show you this awesome feature. You can do this with pretty much anything that's able to be animated in Blender. Let's start with this heart, and we'll animate its rotation along the Z-axis to synchronize with the music clip that I've downloaded. In object mode, select the object and go to the frame where you want the animation to start. In this case, I'll keep it at frame 1. Press I on your keyboard to insert a keyframe, and then either select rotation or press R to have this affect the rotation. Now, go to the animation tab and make sure you're on the graph editor where you would normally see your keyframes and the curves between them. You'll see there are 3 rotation channels in the graph editor, but if we only want to animate rotation along the Z-axis, we can delete or disregard the X and the Y channels. With your channel selected and your cursor in the graph editor, you can press home on your keyboard and realign your view of the channel. Since we only have 1 keyframe, our curve is only a straight line right now. A side note, if you were animating the scale of the object, you might want to do so along all 3 axes. So in that case, you'd select all 3 channels and bake them at the same time. With the Z rotation channel selected, go to Key, Bake Sound to F-Curves. It will prompt you to select the audio file you want to use, find it, and select Bake Sound to F-Curves. Now your graph editor displays this curve. If we press play, you can see it is working, but you can't hear the sound yet. To do that, go to the video sequencer, which can be found in the video editing tab. Go to the frame where you began the animation. In our case, this was frame 1. Press Shift A to insert and select sound. Navigate to the same sound file and select add sound strip. Now if you play your animation, you will hear the sound. The problem is once you bake the curve, it's difficult to change later. There are no keyframes to select, it's just one solid curve. There are a few things you can do. You can limit the range of motion with a limits modifier. In your graph editor, press the N key and go to the modifiers tab on the right. Choose add modifier, limits. Now you can choose a maximum and minimum Y value, which will affect how much the object is allowed to rotate. This still may not give you what you want because it only allows you to cap the top and bottom of the curve. You can instead add an envelope modifier and choose add point. This will allow you to scale the bake curve up and down or offset it in time by moving it left or right with these controls. For transforms, those are scale, location, and rotation, you can bake the action. Do this by selecting the object. Under object, find animation, bake action. This will generate keyframes along the curve. Now you have complete control to individually move these points around. This will work with scale, location, and rotation, but not with other things like material nodes. Just note, this will bake all 9 transform channels, even the ones you weren't using. I recommend deleting the unused channels to declutter your graph editor. So let's go back to this clip, and you can see I used this feature in several different ways. With the torus, I used it to animate the Z rotation. With the heart, I affected its scale. For the ball, I used it on the Z location. For this guy right here, I used a shape key. If you want to learn more about the shape keys, I plan on doing one of my next tutorials on them. On this heart, I animated the strength of the emission shader. These 3 planes have different factors in their materials animated. And here I used it on the thickness of a wireframe modifier. But I baked all of these to the same sound clip, so they all move and change together. Here's a bonus tip. If you're going to use this in material nodes, be creative and think ahead. If you use this on a factor input of a node, like the emission strength here, consider inputting a math node set to multiply. Animate one factor of the math node and use the other to control the volume of the animation. This will maximize your control over the final project. I hope this was helpful. Post your questions in the comment section and please consider subscribing for more. Thank you.